What's up? It's your man, Dr. Will, and you guys know the deal. Let me know what city, what state, what country you are chiming in from. Even if you're watching the replay, let me know what city, what state, what country you are chiming in from. I'm here on the beautiful island of St. Martin. And on this beautiful Tuesday, I want to talk to you about understanding the process, understanding the process. And this thought came to me because I recently hired a trainer. I recently hired a trainer, get back in the gym. And there's some things that I want to accomplish on my road to 50. There's a certain way that I want to look when I hit 50 years old. And so I'm taking this time. I just passed my 45th birthday. So I'm giving myself 5 years to craft the health, the body, and the mindset that I want heading into my 50th birthday. And so I hired this this trainer for a couple of reasons. The first one is, whenever you want to accomplish something, guys, I just think it's a great idea to have accountability in your life. Accountability allows you to stay focused on your goals and stay focused on the mission. So I hired the trainer so I could have accountability. The second reason why I hired the trainer was because I've never been 45 before. And your body at 45 is a lot different than 35 and 25. And so with all the changes that go on with your body, I wanted to understand it more. I wanted to understand how food affects me at 45 now, how eating certain things affects me now. So I have to go to the professional. I'm not an expert in that area, so I went and hired an expert in that area. But here's where it comes to understanding the process. A lot of people, they start things and they don't finish them because of the process or something that happens with inside the process, something that they weren't aware of. So now they think that the process is wrong, or maybe they think that the actions that they're taking are wrong. So one of the things that I did in hiring this trainer, we sat down and I was real clear on my goals, what I wanted to accomplish. And he began to explain to me what the process was going to look like. And that's very important, guys, that you understand the process. So when things start to arise, you know exactly what to expect, right? It's like when you go to the dentist, what's going on, E? When you go to the dentist and they begin to put the Novocaine in your mouth, what they'll begin to explain to you when they are working with that needle, they'll say, you're going to feel a little pressure. You're going to feel something. And the reason why they say that is because they don't want you to jump. They don't want you to be caught off guard, because if you jump, that needle could go in the wrong place and really hurt you. And so they prepare you for the process. They let you know up front, hey, you're going to feel a little pain. You're going to feel a little pressure right here. And that's what you need to know. Whenever you go to do something, you need to invest some time understanding what the process is. I remember when I started out building my companies, I did a lot of research and I did a lot of study on successful individuals. I read like 300 biographies of successful people, people like Walt Disney, people like Henry Ford, people like Mother Teresa, Gandhi, Martin Luther King, all these different biographies of people that accomplished great things. Why? Because I wanted to understand some of the pressures that they went through. I wanted to understand some of the roadblocks that they faced. And so when I was going through my roadblocks and when I was going through my obstacles, I didn't get discouraged. I said, oh, this is normal. This is familiar. I read this before. This is what they said was going to happen. They said that you were going to have some lonely nights. They said you were going to have some nights where you feel as though you've done the wrong thing, right? That maybe you feel like you should quit. I had those nights, but those nights didn't take me out because I had studied the process. I understood the process. I understood that I was trying to accomplish something that the majority of the people that I was hanging out with wasn't trying to do. When I was building a business, most of my friends, and this is not wrong, most of them had a 9-to-5. So some of the aches and pains and some of the anxieties and some of the stresses that I was experiencing, they weren't experiencing those. Because we were on two different roads. And so I didn't get discouraged at what they were accomplishing when they would come up and say, hey man, I just got promoted on my job or whatever it would be. I didn't get discouraged because I knew that I was on a different road. I understood that what I was trying to do was totally different than get a promotion. I was trying to build a company. I was trying to build a business. That looks very different than someone trying to get a promotion. And so when I had those tough nights, those tough mornings, when I got rejected, when I had those rejections, it didn't bother me because I had already read ahead, right? I had already read ahead of the story. I knew that initially I was going to hear more no's than I was going to get yeses. So when those no's were coming in and there were a lot of no's, it didn't bother me per se because it was expected. It was expected. I could prepare myself, right? It wasn't morning. It wasn't having a negative perspective. It wasn't me expecting the no's in terms of being negative, like, oh, I know they're going to say no today. I just knew hearing no was a part of the process. So no didn't discourage me. No didn't discourage me. I flipped the no and it turned me on. It got me more excited because I had read in all these books that you're one no away. Like your next no could be the pathway to your next yes, right? So that was my mindset. My mindset didn't tell me, oh, they said no, everybody's going to say no. My mindset said, oh, okay, the next no is leading me to potentially my first yes. And I didn't know how many no's I had to go through, but I knew if I stopped, I would never get to the yes. And because I had read ahead, I knew that one yes could change my life. And I remember that so many times, one yes at that time in my life, one yes changed my life. One yes for making it, one yes for having the motivation to keep going, one yes for paying off all my bills, one yes, right? I was just one yes. And so understanding the process is so important. So as I was talking to my trainer, he was letting me know some of the reactions, right? Some of the reactions that my body was going to go through, some of the withdrawals. We were talking about a food plan, right? And we were going back and forth on different meats, or should I give up meats based upon what I want to accomplish? Should I go vegan for a little while? We were looking at all different types of options, and he was explaining to me at every option what I could expect, what I could expect. And so now when I go in, you know, one of the things, you know, don't look for overnight results. I'm going to have to put up a lot of upfront work. And when you're, you know, getting your body back in shape and things like that, you have to put up a lot of upfront work without seeing results. So one of the things he was telling me, he was like, don't keep going to the scale every day. Don't keep going to the scale every day, because the change is going to happen on the inside before you see it on the outside. And so by him sharing that with me, once again, you know, I'm not going to go to the gym, work out for a good hour, hour and a half, come home, jump on the scale and expect to see some difference. And so we were talking about time frames. He was telling me about certain time frames, when I could start expecting the changes to occur. When I can expect those. So that's my lesson for you today. You know, whatever you're involved in, whatever you're trying to pursue, understand the process for that, right? It takes, you know, a different amount of time for strawberries to harvest than it does for apples. And it takes a different time for apples than it does for pumpkins, and a different time for pumpkins than it does for cabbage. So you got to understand what you're trying to do, right? Even when you go to the gym, they may be trying to do something different than what you're trying to do. So you got to stay focused on what you're trying to do and understand the process of what you're trying to do. And so that's what I want to share with you guys on this Tuesday. I hope it helps you out. Go out there and do something amazing today, guys, and I'll catch up with you later.